Now back to Outdoors with Larry Ray on ESPN 790. Brought to you proudly by the Tennessee Wildlife Resource Agency, Gaston's White River Resort, and Barton Power Sports.
Hey, good Saturday morning. Welcome back to Outdoors with Larry Ray, and I hope you really enjoyed that interview with Captain Gary Lockey, who will be 93 in August.
And you are
happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
And I'm 72 today. So
and you're,
that's,
you're a Boy Scout.
Boy Scout's what he said. But, hey, that man has served in Vietnam. What? How do you say it now?
Vietnam.
All right, Vietnam. Also, he's also served nine tours in the Pacific in the Navy. But wonderful guy to have on. And you folks know out there, you know, it's kind of goofy. And we're in May, and I'm talking about heated insoles, but I'm going to talk about them because this guy on the line with me right now is what got me started in this thing. And we're not talking about bugs. Thermocell, you think, is, you know, and it's great. It really.
Absolutely.
I used it to the turkey season. I did not have any success like some people did.
Good.
But, you know, and even Steve Turpin killed one on the last day. Did you see that?
I saw that.
Yeah, and everybody else. But no, but my feet were warm all winter, and I am the walking field trial tester for thermocell heated insoles.
You did better than me.
I did, didn't I? Yeah, I did that. We can talk about that.
It's okay. I just froze on the water.
No, that's okay. I got you a jacket. I'll get you some. I bet this guy on the line can get you some to try out there. I know, well. But anyway, wait, we got Josh Silvia, marketing manager at. You pronounce that for me, Josh. Schwab.
Well, Bell Technologies.
Yeah, there you go. In Bedford, Massachusetts. What's right now? When I think of that, I think of.
Cold feet?
No, I don't think of that.
You know what I think of? Great seafood.
You do?
Uh-huh.
Oh, okay. Well, I think about that white whale that Gregory Preck was chasing all the time, you know, and Orson Welles is up on top of that church.
That flew over my head.
It did. Well, that's where it happened. Right, Josh?
Yeah, well, the state's small enough where we're close, but I think you guys are thinking New Bedford, down near the water on the east coast.
Oh, yeah, you're in the regular Bedford, right? So,
we're probably about 10, 15 miles north of Boston, and it's actually pretty funny. We are actually in Burlington now. We switched offices yesterday. So,
really?
Down the road, but yeah, we're actually in Burlington now.
Well, tell our folks, you guys came out with this three years ago, and you made the improvement. You made them better. The response, I guess, has really been pretty phenomenal, hasn't it?
Oh, it has. So back in 2010, 2011, we started, you know, with the original thermocell heated insoles, the red ones that have the remote and you charge them up in the back.
Yes.
Those went over very well. And, you know, naturally, you know, as a company, you got to launch new products and keep improving or else you're going to be left behind by the competition, right?
Right.
So what we decided to do is create our ProFlex version. And the real benefits of that are multifold. But the two that come to my mind are now you have a cushioned, removable battery that pops out of the insole. So now, if you're going out all day, whether you're hunting, fishing, working, all you got to do is carry an extra set of batteries with you, and now they can last you all day long.
Well, that's what I did in this past year, and everybody knows that I have I get cold feet a lot, and it's a circulation problem. But you guys have come up with this, and I had the original which they worked, but sometimes my head worked better than them. I felt like I ran out of time too quick. But
sure.
But what you've come up with now, you guys are coming up with something all the time, and I'm looking at these things. How did this idea develop, Josh? Was it somebody at the and because really thermocell, you don't think of and you know this, and I got all confused with Josh thinking of bugs. You know, this is a different division, right?
Yeah. So, we're actually a different company now.
Entirely,
we do share the thermocell name.
Yeah,
when people ask me that question, I like to ask you a question and response, and you know, usually get a good laugh out of it. What are the two things that drive you out of the woods faster?
Bugs and cold feet.
There you go. That's why we're making what we're making.
Yeah, that's exactly why it is and everything, but. You've made them. What's been the reception? I mean, are you still going to, for 2016, are you going to have something Are they going to be improved, or have you been really, because you guys are always out there trying to improve things?
Absolutely. So on the infills, every single day, any good manufacturer is, just going to make, constant improvements, updates, and things like that. But, the general product offering for 2015 is going to be the same on the insoles. But what we do have this year are thermocell heat packs.
I want to ask you about that. Yeah, you're going to have the heat packs. And how do they work? Same way?
Pretty much, except there's no remote because they're so close to your body.
Okay.
Really, they'll be in your hands or in a pocket most of the time. So there are two styles. We're calling them the hand warmers, which are going to come in a two-pack.
Okay.
They're going to be smaller ones, about the same size as a disposable, and a pocket warmer, which is going to be probably a little bit smaller than a cell phone, but will allow you to heat a larger area of your body.
Really? So you could put it maybe in your backpack or whatever it might be against your back or whatever it might be. Yeah, yeah. Are those going to have the same length of service, so to speak? What are we looking at, for 3 hours, 5 hours?
Probably last a little bit longer. We're estimating up to 6 hours of charge on the low setting.
Okay.
And probably closer to 4 hours on the high setting, which is right in line. They're right in line with the input.
But you'll be able to recharge them?
Yes, sir. Completely battery operated. They recharge through a USB. So, if you have a solar charger and you're out in the backwoods or one of your little power packs nowadays that a lot of people have, you can also charge these things up remotely, which is nice.
So you're
how do they handle moisture?
Yeah, I was going to ask you that.
Water resistant, not waterproof. Really the same as the insole. I wouldn't suggest dunking them in the lake.
Mm-hmm.
But if your hands are sweaty or if it's snowing or raining a little bit, I wouldn't be concerned about them at all.
Gotcha. Well, that's the big problem for waterfowl hunters. When we're out in wet conditions, raining and all, and you get your hands wet, and those little shake up disposables.
Yeah,
they die immediately. So
they die, and I've gone
this
through
would
a
be
bunch
huge.
Of those.
Yeah. Well, those disposable things—if you kind of use them wrong—they don't last five minutes.
No. Well, these are great.
I'm excited about this.
Yeah, I think this is. When will these be out, Josh?
You'll see them on the shelves in the stores. It's come the end of the summer, early fall.
Okay. All right.
I'd say end of August, early September is probably quite appropriate.
Well,
guys actually just hit the nail right on the head with this product. There's no oxygen needed to use it. You don't have to take them out and shake them off or take your shoes off and things like that. These are battery operated, and you can turn them on and off, which is beautiful. So you're not sweating and, making things even colder in the long run. As we all know, when you sweat and you're outside in the cold, you're in trouble.
Yes, yes, yes. Well, and we're talking to Josh Silvia about the new thermocell heated insoles and the new heat packs that are coming out this year. And we definitely want to, once those are out, we want to make sure that we hook up with you, Josh, and make sure that we are able to get some of those things and use them, because I love my little clicker when I'm in my woods. I mean, when my feet, I turn them off when I walk in, and I turn them on maybe not to high level because I've kind of gotten warm going to the woods or wherever I might be, the duck blind or whatever it might be. And then I want some heat, and I do it. Then I take them home, charge them up again. They're ready to go. I don't know how long the warranty is on that, but mine made it through. And I have to admit, some of my old ones are still working.
Awesome. Yeah, and just for all the people listening, the insoles and the heat packs both have a full 1-year warranty. And you know this by now, I think, but we're a very customer service oriented company.
Oh yeah.
So should something happen beyond the 1 year, in all likelihood, we'll be able to take care of you guys, unless you put it in a lake for a week or something like that. I think that's really beyond the warranty.
Well, but they're comfortable too. You're talking about something to put in your shoe, in your boot, whatever it might be. They are comfortable, and they're easier to get out now with that little thing on the back where you just pull them out, put them in, and I love them. Josh, thank you, buddy, for being with us, and glad we got you tracked down and everything. We're all set up, and anytime we can help you down in Memphis, you sent me a couple we're going to give away. We'll stay in touch, because I would not go anywhere without my thermocell heated insoles, and I can't wait to have my heat packs, okay?
Sounds good, buddy. Well, thank you for your support. And if you need anything, you or your team, just let me know, and I know where to find you.
All right, we'll check with you. That's for sure. My team loves that. All right, thank you, Josh.
Yes, we do.
All right.
Thank you, gentlemen. Have a great day.
Great weekend. All right, buddy. Thank you. All right, Josh Silvia, and talking about those heated insoles, and you know,
they really do work well.
They work well, and we're going to get us some more. We're going to give away some on Outdoors with Larry Ray and on the website LROutdoors.com. I know we had a couple other things we were trying to hook up with of events going on, and we'll have those later. Let me tell you about next week's show, because it will be Fifth Saturday, which means that Charlie Covington and Gene Smith will be in studio. Our poet laureate himself, Charlie Covington, not only is he going to have a poem for us next weekend, but he's going to bring along his harmonica. You ought to hear Charlie play that harmonica.
Maybe I need to show up.
Yeah,
and record that so we could see it on LROutdoors.com.
You are very welcome. That's next weekend with Charlie Covington. We're also going to talk to R.V. Patterson is going to be in the studio. I ran into R.V. at the Mid-South Sports and Boat Show, and this is something maybe you need to hook up with Bill on. He's a local guy who's invented a device called Save a Cork and Hook Retriever. It is an amazing thing on how to get – because as much as the baits cost now and things like that, he's got this little device I can't describe it, but he's going to bring it next week and talk – He went to Melrose High School, got a great story about he and his wife, Irene, how they've come up with this. Got their webpage now. We're going to really talk to him. That's R.V. Patterson.
Yeah.
Diane Carver will be on. What a great name to be the Knife and Light product manager for Browning. Diane Carver. She'll be on. John Gordon from Avery's
going
to pop in and tell us about all the things that are going on at Avery. And then John Paul Moody, he's the director of Covenant Ranch and the host of the Sunrise Adventures, a youth sportsman and bow hunter camps up in Buchanan, Tennessee, right out of Paris Landing. And, of course, we'll talk to Marty Marbury and Steve McAdams as we talk next week. That's all on Outdoors with Larry Ray on Fifth Saturday going on. Hey, guys, thank you. Ron
thank
Wall.
You, Larry. And just a reminder, come on out to Performance Marine today for the St. Jude Bass Classic tournament, and tomorrow is the tournament itself coming out. Lots of fun. Want to wish you a happy birthday and remind everybody to practice good water safety this weekend.
And Bill Cooksey, I know you got some things going on with the Mid-South Hunting and Fishing News. You're going to give us a tip?
We do. Next week, the deadline's coming up, so the new issue will be coming out. I'm in the middle of working on that right now.
Got a cover?
We have cover. We have some great editorial. I'm just waiting on Ron Wong to see what he's going to give us.
Oh, my. He has.
I think we'll have some good photos and content from Ron.
We'll do that.
All right. Thank you, Greg Ratliff, for taking care of us. This is Larry Ray reminding you to do each and every week. Does it cost an extra cent to be a good sport? And today is
Happy birthday to Larry.
Keep going. There's two verses on this. All right, we're out of here. Talk to y'all next week.